Hi, Daniel Io here to talk about four ways to remove clicks in Spectral Layers. We have Spectral Layers 10 open and we're using a short example from an unreleased track by Femi J with a clear audible click, which I'll play back now.
One day we bigger than us. One day we bigger than us.
Now the click is occurring around here and they can occur due to mouth noises like tongue clicks and lip smacks or bad buffer settings if the latency is too low. They appear as short vertical lines, which can span the whole frequency range. So to make the click more visible, I'll adjust some of the display settings, like enabling composite view and increasing the minimum amplitude, maximizing the refinement. Now adjusting the FFT sample size and resolution to a lesser extent can affect the quality of some of the tools and processes, but not for the first three examples. So I'll reduce the size to increase the visibility of the click and maximize the resolution. So the first way will be using the click repair tool. First things first, I'll select the time range selection, then go to process, click repair. I'll use the default settings, close the window and deselect the selection, zoom out and play that back.
One day we bigger than us. One day we bigger than us.
So there is still a bit of a remnant of the click down in the lower frequencies. The next way is using the eraser tool. Now if I undo back to where this has been present, I will click at the top of the frequency range. Now as a trick, I'm gonna hover around 400 Hertz. I'm gonna hold shift and then click again. And with that shortcut, it erases from the first click in a straight line to my second click. If I zoom out and play that back.
One day we bigger than us. One day we bigger than us.
So in this case, I'm not hearing any of the click. So this sounds better to my ears. If we move on to the third way is making use of the clone stamp tool. Now this can be considered a copy paste job where I click on a particular frequency range by holding Alt, and that's considered the source. And I'm essentially copying and pasting that where I next click. So if I click and hold, you can see that there is a cross that has occurred, and essentially I'm copying the frequency content from there and pasting it where I'm holding my mouse right now. So again, I'm going to apply the same trick with the eraser tool where I'm clicking. That's my first click. I'm going to hover to around 400 and hold shift, click again, and it's copied the frequency range and pasted it where the click used to be. And this will give a very similar result, at least in this case. Let's play that back.
One day we bigger than us.
And again.
One day we bigger than us.
Again, the digital click has been completely removed. It's sounding good. Now, let's move to the fourth way. And this is using the transient tool where the choice of the FFT size will affect the accuracy in how the transient is captured. So I'll undo, let's bring it back. So what we'll do in this case, we want to increase the maximum height. This should be fine. So we can see just by hovering, it's accurately captured the click. Let's expand a bit. So what I can do in this case, I can just press delete and control D to deselect. Again, this is looking good visually. If I play this back.
One day we bigger than us. One day we bigger than us.
Again, a very clean result there. Can't hear the digital click at all. Now, there is a bonus way, and this is using the Unmix Components tool, which has the potential to be more precise than the previous methods, particularly when preserving the lower frequency vocal tones. So, once again, the FFT size is going to impact the effectiveness as well as the resolution. So let me undo. I'm going to increase to, you know, about, yeah, that seems about fine. 1,536 samples. I will click on mix components, leave the defaults, non-destructive mode. And let's have a quick look visually. So around here, the tonal.
One day we bigger.
Okay, sounds interesting. And the transient. Okay, and the noise. One day we bigger. Okay, so we can see that the click has been captured as part of the noise layer. But as I'm still using the transient selection, let's see if I can't just use that. Okay, let me zoom in a bit. Yeah, we'll go with that. I've highlighted the click. I'm going to delete again. So that's just because I need to have the noise layer highlighted before I hit delete. If I unsolo that, let's have everything in the open. Deselect the portion and let's play that back.
One day we bigger in us. One day we bigger in us.
Once again, the digital click has been removed. It's sounding good. So there you have it. Four ways plus a bonus way on how to remove clicks in Spectralayers. Like, share, and comment if this has been helpful. Take care.